Because being missionaries,
yes,
is something that we're all called to be.
Yes.
We're all called to be ministers of the gospel, whether you have a title or not.
Yes.
Whatever your gift is, whatever your purpose is, you are valuable in the kingdom.
Yes.
However old you are, however young you are, whatever you do, God needs you.
Yes.
Because there are people that only you can reach.
That's right.
Look at this evening as we focus on our theme scripture and connecting the dots and looking at that there are many Christians that are hurting. There are many of us even here that are dealing with things, and we have to address those things so we can be as effective as God would have us to be on the mission field. Amen?
Amen.
We find ourselves seeing in the body of Christ, like I mentioned, hurting people, where you see bitter believers, you see selfish saints, you see anointed alcoholics, you see depressed disciples, right? And so we have to talk about these issues in order to bring healing to us, and then so we can bring the healing power of the Lord to others. And so that's what I really want us to think about on this evening, and allow the Lord to minister to us so we can go out and effectively minister to the world. Amen?
Amen.
So WMU Mission, I read on the website, is we believe missions is a lifestyle. Somebody say lifestyle.
Lifestyle.
Lifestyle. And it goes on to say, therefore, we provide missions education resources for all age levels, from preschoolers to senior adults. Whatever your age or stage in life, we have mission resources for you. Through missions, others may hear of Jesus, the giver of eternal life. That's a powerful mission statement. It's a powerful mission statement. And this evening we're going to focus on, we believe missions is a lifestyle, my lifestyle. And as we know, if you look at Galatians 2:20, the scripture in the King James Version reads, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. In me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself to me. This evening, we're going to focus on the second part of the verse, specifically where it says, I live by the faith of the Son of God. So for a subtitle, our theme is connecting the dots, but the title for this particular message is, how to make my faith real to me.